November, my ass. Maybe we should start calling it Yeswember. Herbs, 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 herbs. Herbs, 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 herbs.
Yes, this is probably my last video about uses and so on. You never know, of course, but the foundation has been laid. Yes, so you cut them up and you put them into the user, preferably an awesome user, but yeah, any slow user is better than no slow user. Let's see. Yes, what I'm going to show you is a recipe where you take green juice, pure green juice, and you mix it up with raw eggs. These are not super optimal because these are bought. They are the highest level of organic in Sweden and so on, but still, you never know. Preferably you want, I don't know, wild raw eggs, or if you have your own chickens or ducks or whatever that can go out and eat in grass and so on. Supposedly these are free range, but yeah, who knows. Anyway, you cut up the greens and put them into the juicer. And then you can add some distilled water. Yes, and then what you do from here is you pour it into a glass jar, preferably a quite large glass jar. And when it comes to green juices, I always recommend wild edible herbs. And as per always, nice places, nice plants, don't destroy, don't deplete. Eat and drink in moderation, and eat and drink in variation, and eat them raw and drink them raw and so on. Yeah, so from here, when you have the herbs mixed with the distilled water, you can add a number of raw eggs. Of course, it's always up to you, so the amount of herbs that you use is up to you. Which herbs you use is up to you. I recommend that you check other sources for information as well, so that you know that they are edible and nutritious and safe and so on. Yes. And then you take the lid with the seal on and put it on top of the jar. And then you simply just shake it. So you don't need a blender for this type of smoothie or juice mix or whatever you want to call it. Yes, it will foam a whole lot. If you want to, you can heat the distilled water up to maximum 42 degrees and so on. And you can also oxygenate it by pouring it back and forth between two glasses. And when you drink it, I recommend that you drink it slowly. And chew a little on it, gargle it and so on. And then, of course, you can follow it up with inner body awareness / body scanning and Shivambu, as per always. This is an awesome little combo. I highly recommend that you try it out, of course. And I don't know yet, maybe it's just a transitional tool or maybe it's a go-to. Who knows? I've done it lots of times, but maybe it's possible to transcend it. Probably. Anyway, try it out. Thank you for watching. Have an awesome now.